You've seen this pyramid breakdown of your electricity cost structure. If you haven't, check it out now. There's a trade-off between certainty and cost. Because the market for electricity is liquid, you're able to choose the amount of price-related risk that makes the most sense for your business. Just be mindful of the fact that the more certainty you require, the higher the premium you pay. If you turn the pyramid on its side, you can see how increased volatility translates into a wider range of possible cost outcomes. The farther left you go, the more fixed the price, and the higher your premium. As you move right, uncertainty about future prices goes up, but your premium goes down. You must strike the right balance between certainty and cost, and the right choice differs from business to business. When determining the right balance between certainty and cost, there are a few basic questions you should consider that relate to key business drivers. How is your budget set? Where do you currently stand in relation to the budget? Does your company attempt to match its sales revenue to its cost when pricing its products? Ultimately, your purchasing strategy must align with your business drivers to make the appropriate choice. Let's look at two different scenarios of how these business drivers might affect the best choice for your electricity contract. First, consider a high-rise office building in downtown Philadelphia. The building is jointly owned by a pair of investment banks, which hold a portfolio of 23 premium office buildings across the United States. Historically, electricity was purchased from the regulated utility at a tariff rate that changed periodically, but was relatively stable. However, rate caps are being removed, and the properties now have the opportunity to buy electricity on the open market. The property managers must provide a 3-year outlook of cost forecasts, but the budget is only set 12 months forward, and the buyer is responsible for assuring that actual costs incurred land within a 25% plus or minus range. The building's leases are utility inclusive, so that changes in price are not passed on to the tenants. Future cost increases would take money straight from the bottom line. Likewise, cost decreases add to the bottom line. In this case, the property manager should consider a product that falls on the left side of the range with more fixed components, but they can afford to accept some price variability. Next, consider a multifamily housing complex with 400 units in the Dallas suburbs. The company is a privately held REIT owned by a joint venture that owns, develops, and manages multifamily communities and mixed-use developments across the United States. The person charged with buying power for the company has purchased electricity in a deregulated market many times. The property managers must provide a 3-year outlook of cost forecasts, but the budget is only set 12 months forward, and energy for the common areas is a small line item. The property's residents assume 100% of each unit's electricity costs, so all future increases are passed straight to the consumer. Only a small fraction of the electricity runs the property's common areas. The company's leaders like to be opportunistic with each facility's purchasing, and don't like paying extra insurance fees to fix costs when they can help it. In this case, the property manager's buyer should consider a product on the float end of the spectrum. GDF SUEZ Energy Resources takes the time to really know your business, how operating costs are structured, key energy usage patterns, and other insights that will help us help you. Whether you're buying for one location or 20, GDF SUEZ Energy Resources helps you better understand the risks involved with purchasing electricity so you can make the best decision possible. Rediscover your options today.